Hello friends, my name is Pradyuman and welcome to my channel VMware NSX Cloud, where I share step-by-step videos for VMware portfolio products. If you like what I shared in this video, feel free to hit the like button and subscribe because it helps me to grow the channel and so that I can continue to create quality content for you. In my previous video, we have completed deployment of Cloud Builder appliance. And in this video, I'm going to demonstrate how to reduce the number of NSX-T managers deployment in VMware Cloud Foundation management domain breakup. It is very essential if you are trying to save resources in your lab environment. However, these steps are not needed for a production deployment. So let's start by logging on to Cloud Builder VM and follow wizard for uploading Excel sheet which we have already populated with required information. Once you are logged in, you will be presented with end user license agreement. Accept it and move next. Now based on hardware, we need to select which VCF deployment we are going to perform. We will choose VMware Cloud Foundation. However, if you are deploying on VxRail, then choose accordingly. As we have already made sure all prerequisites are completed, confirm that you have reviewed them and ensured that they are met. If you have not downloaded and completed deployment parameter sheet, you can do it now and populate required information and then upload file onto Cloud Builder. We are doing this to generate JSON file from our filled Excel sheet. Now wait for upload to finish. Once file is successfully uploaded, log into Cloud Builder with WinSCP. Use admin credentials. Navigate to temp directory and verify that there are no files with Excel or JSON extension. Now hit next on Cloud Builder and wait for JSON spec validation task to finish. As soon as this task is finished, go back to WinSCP and refresh temp directory. As we are connected to Cloud Builder using admin credentials for WinSCP connection, we don't have permission to copy generated JSON file. Hence, we need to log into Cloud Builder using SSH and elevate using sudo-s command. Navigate to temp directory and assign full control to everyone on the JSON file. Now come back to WinSCP window and refresh temp directory. You will find now permissions are changed. Copy file from Cloud Builder to your machine. After copy is complete, it's time to edit the NSX-T spec parameter in the JSON spec file. Look for NSX-T spec. You would find three NSX-T managers are listed as we defined in the Excel sheet. Now we will remove two out of three and save the file. Now we will perform cleanup of the task initiated in the Cloud Builder by removing tables from Postgres DB. This is it for this video. In my next video, we will initiate bring up process. Please feel free to leave feedback or suggestions in the comment section. And don't forget to subscribe.